We've all heard of cats, pigeons, and flies, but there are some members of the animal kingdom that much fewer know of. So join us as we count 10 bizarre animals you've probably never heard of.
Number 10.
Frilled shark. The frilled shark could be a suitable explanation to many of the supposed serpent sightings that are reported, but this is very unlikely as they live and stay in the deepest parts of the sea, where few men have ever been. Named for its 6 pairs of collar-like gills with frilly edges, the frilled shark combines many unusual features. Unique among sharks, the frilled has its first gill slit continuous across the throat. Its long jaws are terminal, at the end of the head rather than underneath as in most sharks, and armed with some 300 trident-shaped teeth arranged in about 25 rows.
Number 9.
Babirusa. The Babirusa is also known as the pig deer and is found only on a few Indonesian islands. They are most notable for their incredibly long tusks. The tusks from their top jaws actually grow vertically upwards and penetrate through their skin, and then curve backwards over the face and towards the forehead. The males of the species usually live alone, while the females form groups with their young. Groups of female Babirusa can contain up to 84 individuals, with none of them being males. While Babirusas are protected in Indonesia and poaching is illegal, hunting remains a significant issue for the species, and they are currently listed as vulnerable and endangered by the IUCN.
Number 8.
Pink fairy armadillo. The pink fairy armadillo is approximately 3.5 to 4.5 inches long, excluding the tail, and is pale rose or pink in color. It is the smallest species in the armadillo family and can only be found in central Argentina, inhabiting sandy plains, dunes, and scrubby grasslands. It has the ability to bury itself completely in a matter of seconds if frightened. It is a nocturnal animal, and it burrows small holes near ant colonies in dry soil and feeds mainly on ants and ant larvae near its burrow. It uses large front claws to agitate the sand, allowing it to almost swim through the ground like it is water. It is torpedo-shaped and has a shielded head and back.
Number 7.
Gerenuk. The Gerenuk is a species of antelope related to the gazelle. The only differences between the Gerenuk and the gazelle is that Gerenuks have a more solid skull and an elongated neck, which is the Gerenuk's most outstanding characteristic. The name Gerenuk means giraffe-necked in the Somali language. The Gerenuk is also known as the Waller's gazelle. Gerenuks live in small groups, some made up of females and their young, and others exclusively males. Solitary males tend to hold specific territories, whereas female groups may wander over a range of 1 to 2 square miles, roaming through several male territories.
Number 6.
Naked mole rat. The forbidding environment of East Africa's deserts is home to one of the most bizarre rodents, the naked mole rat. These beauties wouldn't win any pageants, but they are fascinating animals. Yes, these odd little creatures with pink, wrinkly skin dig and live in underground burrows the way moles do. Yes, they have skinny, rat-like tails. Yet naked mole rats are more closely related to porcupines, chinchillas, and guinea pigs than they are to moles or rats, and are the only species of mole rat that has practically no hair.
Number 5.
Irrawaddy dolphins. The Irrawaddy dolphin is similar to the beluga in appearance, though most closely related to the killer whale. It has a large melon and a blunt, rounded head. Irrawaddy dolphins live in both saltwater and freshwater in South and Southeast Asia, but they now only survive in 3 specific rivers and a few other coastal areas such as around Bangladesh. Each river contains around 100 of the dolphins, and this number is sadly decreasing each year due to accidental fishing incidents that result in the death of the dolphins. It is estimated that around 1 dolphin per month was killed in the last 10 years, leading to an unsustainable mortality rate, and because of this, they are now listed as critically endangered for populations outside India and Bangladesh.
Number 4.
Snub-nosed monkey. The snub-nosed monkey is an endangered species of primate that lives only in China. Snub-nosed monkeys inhabit mountain forests up to a height of 4,000 meters. In the winter, moving into the deeply secluded regions, they spend the majority of their lives in the trees. They live together in very large groups of up to 600 members, splitting up into smaller groups in times of food scarcity, such as in the winter. Groups consist of many more males than females. They have territorial instincts, defending their territory mostly with shouts. They have a large vocal repertoire, calling sometimes solo, while at other times together in a choir-like fashion.
Number 3.
Sunda Flying Lemur. The Sunda Flying Lemur, or colugos as they're otherwise known, has a large gliding membrane attached to the neck and sides of the body. This membrane, which extends along the limbs to the tips of the fingers, toes and tail, is more extensive than in other gliding mammals, whose gliding surface is only stretched between the limbs, with the fingers, toes and tail left free. Colugos are completely arboreal, being nearly helpless on the ground, and are able to travel over 100 meters forward in a single glide, with relatively little loss in elevation. They are generally nocturnal and feed on leaves, buds, flowers, and fruit.
Number 2.
Lamprey. Lampreys are a type of jawless fish that live mostly in coastal and fresh waters, whose adults are characterized by a tooth, funnel-like sucking mouth. They can grow up to a meter long, have large eyes and one nostril on the top of their heads. They attach themselves to fish and suck their blood. Lampreys have been around for nearly 300 million years, and their body structure has remained relatively unchanged.
Number 1.
Star-nosed mole. Star-nosed moles are one of the most distinctive types of mammal. Their noses are hairless and ringed by a unique star of 22 pink, fleshy tentacles. While they are as blind as bats, their snouts are lined with more than 25,000 minute sensory receptors that help the mole feel its way through its underground lair. They live on worms, insects and small fish. The outer tentacles probe for a potential meal, after which the sensors detect if it will be edible or not. When it presses down its feelers, it can do so at incredible speeds.